The mentioned NIVAHL trial was a phase 2 trial, which was conducted at 35 centers in Germany. It was an investigator-sponsored phase 2 trial where patients were randomized between an either fully concomitant anti-PD-1-based treatment with 4 cycles of nivolumab and AVD, or a sequential approach where patients received 4 initial infusions of nivolumab monotherapy, followed by 2 cycles of nivo-AVD, followed by 2 cycles of AVD, each consolidated with 30 gray involved site radiotherapy. This trial enrolled 110 patients with early stage unfavorable, so intermediate stage classical Hodgkin lymphoma. And we recently reported the primary analysis, which evaluated the primary endpoint of the trial, which was complete response rate after the end of study treatment. We saw a very effective treatment, a treatment which was also feasible in this setting. And what was striking to see was that in patients who underwent the nivolumab monotherapy, we saw a very high CR rate of more than 50%, which was unprecedented, since in the relapse setting, the CR rates are around 20 to 30% maybe. And these very early on favorable responses deepened over time. And at the end of treatment, CR rates were more than 90% in both treatment groups. And the progression-free survival at 1 year was excellent, with 100% for the concomitant and 98% for the sequential treatment group, with 100% of overall survival in both treatment groups. As I said before, the treatment was feasible. Toxicities were within the range expected with the anti-PD-1 antibody and AVD chemotherapy. However, we got the impression that some immune-mediated toxicities, such as laboratory abnormalities, skin rash, or lower-grade organ toxicities, developed a bit earlier than in the relapse setting, requiring some dose delay or careful monitoring of the patients throughout this treatment. Nevertheless, the dose density and treatment administration was very good and overall comparable to what we see with standard chemotherapy in this setting. A recent update we showed at the last year's ASH meeting confirmed the excellent early results, and we have since then not seen any events of relapse or progressive disease. So the progression-free and overall survival rates remain extremely favorable at 2 years follow-up. And within ancillary studies, we have been able to show that these patients actually develop complete histologic remissions, as shown by repeated tumor biopsies within days after the first nivolumab dose. And we could also show that there is a substantial reduction of metabolic tumor volume with the first doses of nivolumab, highlighting the therapeutic potential of these agents in the first-line setting.